There are some law schools out there that say if you have more than an X point score difference, you must write an essay explaining why. To me, that's just the stupidest essay question in the world, because the truth is you will never really know why you did better, right? You might have your suspicions, but at the end of the day, it could just be, you know, margin of error. It could be, you know, the way the grading curve worked out. It could be because you had a better day, because you had an awesome LSAT coach, you know, that you didn't the first time. But ultimately, you're not the one grading this thing, right? And so, I don't know. I think I always hate those essays. And so that's just a heads up to applicants that for some schools, if you have a decent size gap between the two scores, they expect you to say something, which is asinine. But there you go. Most schools don't, though, which is more sensible.
That's a great question. Is there anything an applicant definitely should not say to explain a significant score difference?
And God, this comes up so often. I'm not a good test taker. Oh, you know, because law school, or I have crippling test anxiety. Law school is all about high stakes tests. And then you have the mother of all high stakes tests at the end, you know, called the bar exam. So if you're basically already out there saying, I'm not a good test taker, that is not confidence inspiring. So yeah, I would take that completely off the table.
Okay, good. Thanks for that. Because a lot of people will say that to me.
They do.
My scores don't reflect my true potential. It's like the reverse splitter, high GPA, low LSAT.
Right.
Which is nice for academics, but a lot does ride on one test on the bar exam too.
Yeah, if I had a dollar for every time someone said, this score doesn't represent my true potential, and even when they keep retaking it and cluster around the exact same score, none of them represent this person's true potential. And you know, at some point you have to just concede that for whatever the LSAT is measuring, maybe it is actually measuring it quite consistently and quite accurately.
Thanks for tuning into the show. Please subscribe if you haven't done so already to be notified of new episodes as I release them. And feel free to reach out if you need anything at all as you move forward with your prep. I'm happy to help however I can. In the meantime, I wish you all the best and take care.